You'll never try, you'll never know, right? What? I only have one day to prepare.
I'm totally lost.
Because I know that I will have the result. My hands are trembling.
Wow. Wait. A lot of languages.
I got the internship.
I'll be strong.
Hey guys, this is the series of videos where I share my experience in searching for and finding my first internship in tech industry as a software developer. During this period, I recorded videos where I shared my experience, my thoughts, my plans, and my doubts about searching for the first internship. So, enjoy.
So it's Friday today. I don't even remember the date because it's been like, I don't know, every day seems to be the same. I've been working a lot on school projects and because I really want to progress fast and do my best, let's say. Yeah, today is the 12th of February, March. The 12th of March, and I recorded the first video, if I'm not mistaken, on the 7th of March. And in this video, I promised to make a list of companies where I want to work. It's technical stack and the languages which they use, the other technologies, so that I can like focus on probably learning new technologies, not only the school curriculum that I'm doing now. Even though I don't have time for that. But yeah, we'll come back. I will explain to you in this video. And I did this kind of table, organizing it like the name of the company, the technical stack, some my comments, what does this company do, and like the link to the job description, something like that. I think I only did, I started with the website called Welcome to the Jungle, which one of my friend from Paris recommended me. And there are like lots of job offers there. And I think it's primarily for France. There were some other countries there listed there, but there were not so many offers from other countries. Primarily, it was from France. And the thing is that, like, first I was so excited. Like, yeah, there are lots of stuff going on with interns. People really want to hire interns. There were also some descriptions that, most of the time it's like people, they ask you to have a degree or to be like studying to be in a university on the last year of your studies in order to do the internship there. But in some job description it was written like, yeah, the degree in IT sphere or a boot camp like 42 school epitech or equivalent. And I was like, wow, 42 school is really recognized in France. And I was excited about that. But I was also frustrated. Why was I frustrated? Because like I was searching for primarily backend jobs. And the thing is that like I understood that I don't have like preferences even on the sphere, like the role banking companies, data companies, e-commerce companies. And I was like, I have no idea where I want to work. I just want to have the experience in programming. Please take me. Something like that. And also, like, I was searching for, like, the answer. Which language is the most popular? Do I need to learn something extra from what we do at school? And I didn't answer this question really because, yeah, if you're not familiar with programming and the languages and you want to know the answer, based on my research of French market, there were companies who used Python language, primarily Django framework, then also Golang, which goes with Python most of the times. Then, which also was sometimes like Go or Python and Go. Sometimes there was PHP. Also, there was a lot of Java. than JavaScript, not JS framework, and also Ruby on Rails. And I was like, wow, wait, a lot of languages. I need to choose one. And the thing is that, like, on school curriculum, the final project that we're gonna do before, like, our internship, it's the backend is written, must be written on Ruby. But I'm not sure if I need to study more or not. So that were the questions that I was asking myself, and I was like my mind was blown that day. And a little bit of off-top story that made me feel better afterwards. So on Tuesday, I'm not sure if I shared with you or not, probably on Instagram, that I also started on October dancing. I took a dance class, but it's only 2 times a week, about 3 hours per week. So it's not that much. And also I do not train myself at home. And I remember myself in October when it was very hard for me to even like remember all of the movements, I don't know, of hands and legs and like the order of movements, right? And right now, like on Tuesday when I went to this dance class, I was like super, like my mind was blown, and I decided, okay, so this is the time when I need to like not to think about anything of the code, of my career opportunities and so on. I'd rather be concentrated on dancing, and that's it. And that's what I did, and that was super cool training that day. That made me realize that even though I didn't put much effort on that, I still have the progress that is visible. That, I don't know, I really liked the result that we filmed ourselves at the end of the lesson. And I saw myself and I was like, wow, Anna, is it you who couldn't even remember like the order of movements, and now you're like dancing something like a piece of the dance that you learned within 1 hour, and right now like it's looks nice. And I was really proud of myself, even though like it was not perfect obviously, but I was really proud of myself. And after that I came back home and I was like, yes, I can do anything, you know, like even though I didn't put much effort on that. But I was having this dance classes regularly during 6 months. And I never missed classes, almost never missed classes except when I was sick. What can I say about programming? It is my life right now. And if I do it like regularly without frustration, without like doubting myself, seeing like the big goal behind all of this, I will have way better results here, you see? Just I also see the progress even now, but that made me realize that everything is possible, you know? You need to be regular, like consistent in what you do. And that's the key point. And then I was like dreaming, and I decided to search for some jobs, intern jobs in companies where I really want to work, which products I use. Like, I don't know, first thing that came up to my mind was TikTok. It's owned by ByteDance company, which is Chinese company, so really related to me. And there were so many like intern jobs there. And I was like, wow. Yeah, and there wasn't written like you should know Java or, I don't know, this framework particularly. No, it was written like most of all computer science, C++, I think there was mentioned C++. Java was mentioned there. I think the backend is written in Java, that's why. So, and it gave me hope, because like, if you're an intern, it means that you don't need to be pro in any of the technologies because you're the intern and you're going to learn in the company. But also, it made me feel a little bit just doubting myself, because in the job description it's always written that, except for like French companies that I mentioned, you should be enrolled in a university program, bachelor degree in computer science, last years. So, but I don't know, I'll still like gonna apply, because who knows, maybe it's my chance. Yeah, why not? It will, I don't know, it will take like half an hour to submit the application form, write some words about yourself and resume, cover letter, so on. But I think like most of the time it will be the same, so just gonna change some couple of words about why you choose this particular company. But other stuff would be like the same for many job vacancies. Yeah. But also, like, I was very happy that such things exist, but at the same time, the deadline, submission deadline, is like April, so they are hiring for summer, but the interview process is going on right now, and I was like, no, I'm not ready, guys. And but at the same time, I think I need to apply. I will apply anyway, to other companies, not only TikTok, obviously. And the first thing that I'm gonna do is that I will organize my GitHub repository, because right now it's my projects that have no description. I only have the description, the README file for only the last project that I did, because by that time I realized I need to describe my work, to give the instruction how to execute the file, how to use the program, what is it all for, something like that. And why is it important? I also asked one of my friends who works as a software developer and who himself conducts the job interviews for newcomers for the company where he works, and he said that, yeah, definitely GitHub is important. He said that sometimes they look for the repositories, most of the time it's like commit history, and also he said, yeah, it would be nice if you had descriptions for your projects, because sometimes they also look through the projects that you did. Yeah, so this is like action that I'm gonna take. Also, my LinkedIn profile, because right now it's it's the old one, which is focused on the previous job I did, so I need to change it. And the other interesting and important thing that I forgot to mention is that also I decided to Google all of the companies where I want to work, which technical stack do they use. I don't know, Airbnb, for example, is written on Ruby, which made me think, okay, yeah, there are no job opportunities right now for Airbnb as far as I searched in the website, because, yeah, we know that travel industry right now sucks, in COVID times, but probably they will have in the future. And so I also Googled like Tesla, and look for what was written in their like intern's job description. It was written something like that: nice to have experience with performance software design, object-oriented C++, and or hardcore lower level C code. And I was like, wow, it's me. Hardcore level C code. I don't think like that's what they are looking for, but probably why not to apply. Yeah, that was the thoughts that I had that night. And also, I understood that there are apprenticeship programs in the companies from the United States, and that also gave me a lot of hope. In apprenticeship programs, it means that apprenticeship programs are designed for people who are not coming from the computer science background, who don't have the computer science background, like the degree at the university, who learned how to code themselves or in a boot camp like me. And so I think I'm gonna apply for these programs as far as I like Googled, for sure. LinkedIn has such a program, Amazon has such a program, and I think a lot of companies should have such a program in the Valley. Yeah, but it seems like they have very long hiring process, but it doesn't scare me. I'll be trying a lot of stuff, and you will see in my videos, and we'll see where we'll come. You know, it is an interesting journey. I try to think of it like it's a journey full of failures, small failures, big failures, full of probable success that I'm gonna have at the end, because I believe that everything we do, it bears fruit in the future. This example with dance class made me realize that, like, showed me in the very, very clear example this thought. I hope you also felt this analogy and right now kind of understand me. Yeah. So that's what I wanted to say. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you like what I'm doing, the way you can support my channel is to subscribe, to watch my other videos, and to share my channel, my videos with your friends, family members, with people you know, people who are interested, who might be interested in programming, IT sphere, or career change. Thank you very much again. See you in my next videos. Bye bye.